Okay, it's a happy day in the workshop because Zoe is going back together. Right now she is all apart, sitting on top of my table saw. And the other night when I took her out for a night spin to test her new amber lights, she took a little abuse. And I had to do a fix to the head pan and tilt mechanism. If you notice in there, there is a white servo horn attached on there, and there used to be a red one. And I guess I was a little rough on her, and her head was bouncing up and down a lot, and it stripped out the servo horn. So that's supposed to be a little bit harder servo horn, and I've got some aluminum ones on order. And the other thing I did to her is this screw here just goes into a little tiny aluminum shaft that was in there. And the problem was that slides in a bearing and the whole head mechanism would slide left and right as this is oriented. And the problem with that is the servo horn there would come off to the left, and if it just came off a little bit, then that connection is weakened and it stripped out the servo. But it's possible that it could have come all the way off. So what I did over here on that aluminum shaft, I cut a little piece of black rubber fuel line, and I cut a slot in it so I could basically stick it in this slot over that shaft, and then the hose, since it was rubber, it just pulled itself back together. And that bigger hose there will keep the head from moving this way. Okay, another thing that my rough riding did was it kind of broke loose some of this woodwork in the back here. And it was, normally there was like a threaded rod that comes up through that hole there. And that was the only thing holding this whole body mechanism on. And as things grow, they get heavier. And that connection and the wood under here was not strong enough to support all that, so some of that glue broke loose underneath here. So what I've done now was I've drilled a hole for another threaded rod and wing nut, and I'm thinking about putting one there, but I don't know if I need it or not. Okay, I've got Zoe tilted over on her back now. Wanted to show you the additional bracing that I did under here. This piece is new. This piece is new. There's a little corner brace in there. That's new. Basically, it broke the glue joint on this piece under here, because and the attachment point is up here, and I guess this thing here flexed too much. This piece of paneling flexed. It broke that glue joint. Didn't do any damage other than the glue joint. What I did was I peeled the panel back a little bit and squirted some glue in there, and I did that on this side, and then I clamped it real good. And I added these new pieces, this piece and this piece. And then to hold all that additional bracing in there, I added some more screws, to hold that in there. And I added an extra screw right there in the middle. And then here on the edges, 1, 2, 3. I had this hole already drilled, but I didn't have a screw in it. So now it's got a screw in it. So this has all been strengthened. This has all been strengthened. And so I'm happy because she's going back on, because I want to do some programming, and the speech recognition goes through the head, and so that's all got to be hooked up again. And the way this thing works is there is a USB cable that comes down from one I/O board, the fidget board, and the fidget board's got a USB hub on it, so the other USB connections come off of that. And there's some heavier wires for 12 volts that goes to the body, and there's the jack for the audio that goes to an amplifier that then goes to the speakers. So three connections, and this whole body section is off. I'm thinking about putting some kind of limiting strap or shock absorber or something on that head, because the head has a lot more mass than that servo can handle, I think. And it's not a problem when it's standing still and when it's moving around inside, but when it's outside bouncing around, all the mass of that head, it gets accelerated, and then the robot tries to stop it and it strips out the servo. So it's only from bouncing around outside that's a problem. And the servos I have in there are metal gears. They're high tech. I'll put them on the website somewhere where what the actual part number is. But she's going back on today. Okay, I'll show you what I did to the computer section. This is a really good shot of the computer section without the body attached, so you can see more of the stuff inside. Over on the right edge, the left edge, what is this? Left edge. You get a better view of the fidget board and that weird looking little circuit board there is it's a connector. And I used to have a board on there that had series dropping resistors for the LEDs. Well, basically it's a connector that turns 90 degrees. It's got this rainbow cable on it. And that runs over to this new 8-channel LED driver that I built. And I just wired it by hand. The wiring isn't pretty, but it works. And that is for the new amber LEDs, which you will see in another video. Basically, that takes a 5-volt TTL signal from the digital output ports on the fidget board and drives the LEDs. And I had to add a whole bunch of extra wiring stuff in there for the LEDs. So there's room for 8, but I only put 7 of them in. For some reason, I'm ignoring the back control panel section. But over in this section again, there's the fidget board. And I got a piece of fancy wood in there. The fidget board is mounted on the same board as this little device here, which is just a power connector. And that's for the 12 volts. But wait, my batteries are 24 volts. Where's the 12 volts come from? Well, over here on this side, is a DC-DC converter, and that takes the voltage from the batteries, which can be anywhere between 24 and 18 volts, or lower if things are bad, and converts it to 12 volts. And it's even got a USB port on it, so I can actually monitor the batteries when I get all the right DLLs loaded into the right program. So I can monitor the battery voltage from here, and that's where the 12 volts comes from. And I need the 12 volts to drive the fidgets, and now the 12 volt amber LED marker lights. And this thing over here, the big blue thing, is a power capacitor that I have across the voltage that before it goes into the computer, and that's I used to run without it, but I thought, why not have a little extra safety in there? When the motors start and stop, there's possibility of a current surge or a dropout. So the capacitor's there for that. There's a better view of my 8-channel driver board with 8 big power MOSFETs on it and a cable in the way. So what I did here on the computer section is to add the studs. I made sure everything was all lined up. And I drilled these holes out with a number 7 drill. And I tapped the wood. Now, that's not really the strongest thing in the world. This wood is relatively hard. It did take the threads. It didn't just slide the tap up and down in there. So it took the threads, but then I cut my stud off of a 3-foot piece of threaded rod, 1/4 20, and tapped it out to 1/4 20. Then I coated the bottom of this stud with JB Weld, and then I screwed it in there. And it sat there the recommended 4 to 6 hours overnight, actually. And what I did before I put it in there was I masked off the wood around it so that the JB Weld wouldn't get all over the wood. So the new stud is in there. There's the old stud. And I got a question for you guys. Leave it in the comments. Should I paint my wing nuts bright red? Because all of my other connectors on here, screws, are red. So that's red. So I was thinking about doing that. Where'd you go? There it is. Nope, that's the new one. That's the old one. It's red. So should I paint my wing nuts? What do you guys think? Leave me a comment. Okay, here goes nothing. Never been on there before. This is the first time I'm letting you guys see it live. Hoping that those studs line up. Well, they're fighting me. They don't want to line up. That's what it needed, a little extra force. Don't force it, just get a bigger hammer, right? There she goes. All good. Okay, there you have it. all buttoned up with her new wing nuts. Both sides. I wonder if I should paint those red. Everything else is red. Okay, here's another test. Zoe is not connected to her power supply. There's the wires laying there. She's running on batteries. Her batteries are, shoot, I can't read that.
Oh.
23 something, 23.29 volts. And she's currently pulling 1.02 amps. Now, if you look up here, the driver board is on, the servo. That is so weird. Now the servo is off.
Do you think we all are created for a purpose? I would like to think so.
Radio receiver looks like it's off. Oh, that's on, that's off. Okay, and I've got her in autonomous mode. And she is running.
Do not touch me, please. I would receive no satisfaction from it. All right. You have my attention.
Okay, the mic is off now. There's the amber lights.
Marker light bulb is now on.
Oh, I can control them with this button now. If I push it one time, they go into blink mode. And if I push it
marker light mode is now two.
Another time, they go into scan mode.
Marker light mode is now zero.
And if I push it a third time, they go off. And I have Zoe sitting up on her stand, so her wheels are not on the ground. And the e-stop switch is up, which means her motors are live. And I have over here, I have the motor control program on. Up here is the head servo program. You've seen that before in other videos. The motor control program, I don't think you've ever seen that. It's got a readout on my battery voltage. It says it's 22.44 volts. And that's being read from the DC-DC converter. And if I were to press move forward, then the wheels are turning forward. And if I were to press turn left, only the right wheel spins. And if I was to push turn right, only the left wheel spins. And if I was to push move backwards, both the wheels are moving backwards. And it's got other settings on here. I can do a pivot left and a pivot right. And I can use these slides to control the two channels that go to the saber-tooth board. And over here I have different speeds, ahead full, head half, head slow, head dead slow. So that's dead slow. You can hear it. That's slow. Half, you can hear that's a little faster. And I'm gonna click a head full. You can hear that, that's a little faster. And I'm gonna hit all stop. And she stops. What are we going to do tomorrow, brain?
That's a good question. Enabling demo mode. We are going to do the same thing we do every day, Pinky. Try to take over the world.